Dropshipping on Facebook Marketplace is a crazy profitable opportunity. Even the newest person can start dropshipping today and in just a couple weeks to a month scale a store to, say, thousands of dollars in profit. I see it happen all the time. But there are certainly some issues with the platform, and in today's video we're going to tackle those issues so you can be aware of them and understand, you know, what you can do about them if they happen to you. So the first major problem you'll face as a seller on Marketplace is if a buyer says that an item didn't arrive, it didn't arrive. Period, okay? It doesn't matter if you have the tracking number and proof, you know, from the carrier specifically that it was delivered. Facebook will always side with the buyer, okay? And this is nothing new. This has been true for Amazon sellers for a while now as well. Unless you get signature confirmation, the platform won't see it as proof. Now, just the same, if a buyer files a chargeback, again, it's tough luck for you as the seller most of the time. Now, on personal marketplace specifically, half the time they don't even notify you, probably over half, I would say like 80% of the time, they don't even notify you about a claim or a chargeback. And even if you do get notified or you happen to notice, there's no appeal built in. There's no way to actually appeal it most of the time. And there's no rhyme or reason to it, okay? Now, there is a way to appeal on shops, but my success rate personally has been downwards of 20%. Furthermore, the same thing that makes it easy for beginners to start is the same thing that actually makes it hard for you to scale and stay up long term, and that's that the barrier to entry is so low. All you ultimately need is a Facebook account in one of the countries with a shipping option to start. That means that you're competing potentially with a large number of people, and new sellers are starting and selling every single day. There are also so many bugs since it's new. I can remember that I couldn't list from a computer, which made list, like I could list from mobile, but not a computer, which made listing 150 items a day almost impossible. Now, currently right now, I actually can't edit current listings on one of my accounts, but the other one I can. And also on top of that, the seller dashboard on everything, even mobile, constantly lags out, and that's if you even have a seller dashboard to begin with. Which then ties me into the next point, which is there's different features rolled out to different sellers at different times, and there's different features rolled out to different sellers mobile and different sellers, you know, desktop at certain times as well. That's gonna be a headache, and it's very, very hard to manage and understand what you have access to, when and where. Another major issue is the ability to connect to Marketplace for new shops is currently disabled while they work on a better selling buying experience. That obviously is a good thing overall in the long term, but that means that newer sellers are forced to list on personal Marketplace only, and it's very, very easy to get your best-selling products sniped from a personal Marketplace, or at least much easier than if you were listing from like the ambiguity of a shop where people can't necessarily find your shop as easily. And the last major issue, but probably the biggest, is the constant bans and constant suspensions simply for no reason, simply because like the Facebook algorithm or a bot just triggered on something that you did. Now, this is part and parcel for selling on Marketplace, and if you sell long enough, this will certainly happen to you. I've honestly probably been suspended around 50 times. That is no joke, 50 times at least. But I will say one thing is Facebook has gotten a lot better at, you know, reversing these obviously wrongful suspensions, and now I usually get my accounts back within a few hours, but I've honestly heard horror stories of other people like losing access for weeks and then finally getting it back, which obviously can be a major issue if you haven't marked the orders tracked or you can't mark current orders with tracking numbers, because that means that you'll be out the money for the sales, and you'll also be out the money for the orders if you've already, if they're dropshipped and you've already placed those orders as well. Now, all of these issues said, I'm actually really excited about the direction of Facebook Marketplace as a whole. What started out as like a stupidly simple platform like Craigslist, where buyers and sellers would literally just exchange kind of, you know, goods in person, has morphed into something that looks like it's more of a platform that can rival the potential of Amazon, okay? And I do not say that lightly. I've sold on Amazon for almost a decade now, if not over. Amazon has the customer service, the brand trust, the logistics to beat everybody easily. I get that. I'm not combating that, and that's probably going to stay that way for a while. But Facebook is constantly improving their user experience both on shops and on Marketplace, hence, you know, all the bugs that are happening currently. And you can tell that they're putting a lot of manpower into it and a lot of effort, and I've honestly been blown away just by going through and playing around to see what it looks like as a buyer in shops and Marketplace and the whole experience. Simple things like The live shopping feature, for example on shops, are ways that eBay, Amazon, Walmart, etc., they can't compete with Facebook. Don't get me wrong, Marketplace has a long way to go for sure, but what I'm seeing is certainly encouraging, and it's, you know, already a force to reckon with in the e-commerce and dropshipping space currently. I believe it'll take over, you know, pretty much everyone else with the exception of Amazon fairly soon. So whether you want to just get started dropshipping on Facebook Marketplace, or you already have some listings up but you're interested potentially in finding like more hot selling products, the video up in the right hand corner will cover 10 hot selling products that you can list right now to get sales on Marketplace. I hope you got a lot of value out of this video. If you got any value from it whatsoever, please give it a like. I genuinely appreciate it. Until next time.